2 years after independence, with the Skatalites at their peak, was the golden age of Jamaican ska. Not that the musicians saw much of a reward for it. To make a living, many of the most talented joined the other Jamaicans on the boat to England.
Little Miss Muffet, she sat on a tuffet, eating her curds and whey.
With Jamaican musicians joining the increasing Caribbean population in England, the influence of ska started to spread. Whoa.
We used to go down to number 9 Millennium Crescent, where there was a little cafe with a little jukebox, and you'd get some food. And I always remember Carolina was on the jukebox, and in back there was a kitchen with a chef, and you can get meat and rice. That must have been 1961. And at the same time, Buster came over from Jamaica, and you felt like you were at the start of something there.
Like the lucky old sun, give me nothing to do but roll around heaven all day.
Ska took off in Britain. It was distributed on the Blue Beat label, which was how it became known there. Initially an underground scene, it was the music of choice for the scooter-riding mods. But by 1962, had become a big enough phenomenon to warrant a West End club. Soon, Count Supple's Roaring Twenties in Carnaby Street became one of the hippest venues in town.
It was a late night dive. Maltese, prostitutes, strippies, girls, the old of the West End. Everybody, white, musician, because they come down, the Rolling Stones. They were scruffy, all of that stone. Because they used to play round the corner at a club called The Scene in Wilmin Street, downstairs. A girl named Sandra used to run it.
By 1964, Jamaican record entrepreneur Chris Blackwell was convinced he could get a UK hit with a ska record. He had the singer, Millie Small. He now just needed the song.
I came across this tune called My Boy Lollipop. And I thought, wow, this would work great in a kind of a ska beat. And I'd also brought over Ernest Wrangman, who I was trying to really get happening. Ernest did the arrangements, and we went in and recorded it. And I was so excited about it because I just knew it was a hit. It just took off so fast. Within a year, it sold about 6 million all around the world.
We started to get hits in England because that's where it became an international music, especially with My Boy Lollipop by Millie Small. That put us on the map. So the uptown people started to take note to make it a national sound rather than downtown sound.
Yes, this is ska, original and indigenous. These instruments are playing a monotonic grassroots rhythm.
As uptown Jamaica and the rest of the world joyously accepted ska, downtown the music and the mood were changing.
The ska was upbeat. It expressed how the spirit of the people was. And then after, people start to observe and say, oh, this independence, I'm not really independent. What's going on? The music slowed down. Let's rock it steady and see what's going on. Slow down. Poverty breeds crime. You wake up in the morning and you don't know where next meal is coming from. You know, all kind of things start going through your mind.
For if he's rough, he's against the world. He's against the world.
Right up, don't you know
By 1966, downtown Kingston was a lawless place. This was the era of the so-called Rude Boys, the ruthless gangsters who terrorized the nation.
The Rude Boys are coming out dance, man. No care you dress in a three-piece suit. Them guys that change things, them just coming out shorts and no shirt and hard turn up back way. And the girls flap them and them just said, so that's how Rock said the name they come in, you know. And the DJ have to play when he reaches, say, cry tough with Alton Ellis. And anything you can do, I can do it better. I am the toughest. And them chew a box of beer in the air and it mash.
All I need from you is a good conversation.
As things hotted up in downtown Kingston, people sang. And most of them escaped into the old-fashioned boy meets girl love songs. This was Rocksteady, Jamaica's first pop music, the golden age of Jamaican singers, and for many it was the most glorious phase in Jamaican music.
I never felt this way before. I know there is some way today.
It all came from the American R&B music. You know, because we're always being influenced by the Impressions, all them soul R&B groups.
We would listen to a Dionne Warwick song and try to sing it exactly as Dionne did it. If you are a group, you would try to study the Supremes, Martha Reeves and the Vandellas, if there was a group who comes from abroad to our shores. We would want to go and see them because they have something to teach us.
It's a cultural thing for Jamaicans to sing. In the ghetto, you'll find more singers than anywhere else too, because, you know, it's a thing that, you know, it's a thing we used to pass the time away. It's a thing you used to soothe your spirit, your soul, you know.
I've been touched by an angel.
She's on a progressive chart and with her work for where she wants. With enough confidence and never yet say she can't. What? Tender loving where she up. Healing the broken heart from she coming on my life. Me no stop advance, what? Rearrange my lonely life and turn it right from start. No, I'm happy with this woman and we will never part. Me know she clever and she smart.
I've been touched by an angel.
La, 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 la. There was no thought of any money or anything else more than honesty, sincerity, and purity. And that is what I think that music is full of. That, you know, that is why it's lasting so long.
His songs lived. You'll have a song, man, 1 year straight. Send it for 1 year, not a little thing like some tune come on yourself for 1 month and done. Them tune they sell and never ever die. People still buying them. My biggest sales in this store is who is this? And I have everything up to date and I'm up to date.
Rocksteady saw a power shift in the music industry. It was still dominated by the former sound system bosses, but Coxon and Studio One would never be quite the same force again. Many of the artists, like the Paragons, Alton Ellis and the Melodians, promptly signed up with his old rival Duke Reid, who still ran his own sound system and realised the potential of the more easily danceable Rocksteady beat.
This guy was very fast. He had to spin, he had to dance, he had to dance in a fast pace. So what we did was, at the time, most of them had the same bass line, because the bass man didn't have enough time to emphasise on his bass line. So what we did was cut it down a little, so the bass man could more move his fingers and have a line. So that's how he comes to have these reggae lines.
Rocksteady lasted 18 glorious months, but finally there was no escaping Jamaica's worsening conditions. Bass lines became heavier, and the subject matter more socially concerned.
I'm a loot, I'm a shoot, I'm a weird.
That's me, give me money.